you later.
Thank you.
Take a video.
Yeah.
I'm going to swim with the Dolphins now. I'm going to swim with the Dolphins.
I don't know how to swim.
I just want to swim, yeah. Yeah, I just want to swim.
With a renewed inspiration to want to help protect these animals and the planet for our future. Now we open Dolphin Bay as a way to bring the wonders of marine mammals to our guests. As Shadow, Kai, and DJ serve as ambassadors for their wild counterparts, and we'd like to thank our corporate sponsor, Water River, for making it all possible. Now today we're going to start off by introducing you to our boys individually. He's the youngest at 15 years old. He came to us from the Brookfield Zoo in Chicago, and he is Shadow's baby brother. Wave hello to little DJ. Up next, he's 17 years old. He also came to us from the Brookfield Zoo in Chicago, and he is the lightest in color of our three dolphins. Say hi to Kai.
I know.
And last but certainly not least, he's 19 years old. He came to us from the National Aquarium in Baltimore, and he weighs in at over 450 pounds. This is Shadow. Now, as you can see, though, Shadow, Kai, and DJ are extremely intelligent animals. Because of the tight bond that they share with our trainers, our relationship is built, which allows the trainers to interact with the boys in and out of the water. So today our trainer, Nicole, wants to show you just how well our boys can build a relationship.
I volunteer.
Hola.
Firefly.
She waves. Oh my god, so cute.
She just waves and she waves.
So they're telling her. Film video.
So they're telling her to do anything they want.
Because she's jumping.
You're rubbing your belly.
We're too tired to go to sleep. To 10 million fires.
Oh my god. Oh my god! How cool, they get to touch
you. Yeah, it'd be cool, right? You start to see
them. So, la la.
Well, as you can see, Shadow Kai and DJ have a new best friend in the audience. Looks like two new best friends in our audience today. Now, here at the Texas State Aquarium, we train in several different ways. And one way we train here is through capturing behavior, which is exactly how it sounds. Often when the boys are playing, the trainers will sit out here with a bucket of fish, and if they see or hear something they like, they will blow their whistle and then reinforce that behavior. By doing so, the dolphin is more likely to repeat the behavior. We can then pair the behavior with a hand signal and ask for it again in the future. So right now, looks like DJ wants to show you a move that he came up with all on his own. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, please put your hands together one more time for our Marine Mammal Training Team. That's our trainers, Nicole and Lacey, the boys in the water, Shadow, Kai, and DJ. We want to thank you all for being such a great audience. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask. And we hope you enjoy the rest of your day here at the Texas State Aquarium. Goodbye, everyone. Well, as you can see, he's very creative. He came up with that move all on his own. Way to go, DJ.
Keep it right on her.
Well, right now we come to a portion of the show where I want to give an audience member an opportunity to gain a token of appreciation from the Texas State Aquarium. So do I have a volunteer in the audience that thinks they know about dolphins? Let me have... We have you right here in the red and you in the pink. We're going to have a fun little competition of adults versus kids. Who do you think's going to win? I'm just kidding. All right, what's your name, sweetheart? Mickey and you, ma'am?
Beth.
We got Mickey and Beth. Mickey, come stand right over here. So I'm going to ask y'all some questions, and we're going to start. It's through shaping behavior with the use of a tool called a target. Now, our hands or fingers can be targets. Or we can use what we call a target pole. A target pole is basically a long stick with a blue and white buoy attached at the end of it. At a very young age, the dolphins are taught to touch this buoy with their mouth or rostrum and then follow it wherever it goes. By doing so, the trainers can elicit all types of behaviors, such as asking the boys to move their head up and down, side to side, to spin in the water, and then jump out of the water. When teaching new behaviors, we'll use approximations or baby steps, slowly phase out that target pole, assign a hand signal, then we'll ask for the finished behavior. Now, one finished behavior is what we call our perimeter bound, which the boy's going to show you, and then the Kai wants to show you what a V-spin would look like. All right, way to go, Kai. Well, that's how we train here at the Texas State Aquarium. Now I want to tell you why we train. one very important reason is for exercise. So by a show of hands, how many of y'all actually go to the gym and exercise? Okay, never mind. I'll ask another question. How many of y'all like to go swimming? Yeah, that's much, much better. Exercise is extremely important to our boys here because they have to keep up that lean, mean Dolphins physique. So here's a little exercise move Shadow wants you to try the next time you're out at the pool. So what do y'all think? Are y'all going to try that when y'all go swimming?
Yes.
Now the absolute most important reason why we train here at the Texas State Aquarium is for education. A lot of people think it is okay to go out and swim or interact with the wild dolphin out here in Corpus Christi Bay. But does that sound like a safe idea? No, you're right. It's very, very dangerous, but it's also illegal. A dolphin is like any other wild animal. As cute as they are, they can be very unpredictable. Our hope here today is that you have built a bond with our boys and that they have inspired you to want to go out and help protect their wild counterparts. Remember, only we truly are the key to a better future. Well, as you can see, this job takes